Good morning, dear children. Welcome to the math session. So already we have learned the exercise number 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, and 1.4. In 1.4, we have solved question number 1, question number 2, and question number 4. So today I am going to solve the question number 3 and question number 5. The question number 3 is, okay, I will read the question. Suppose this is from playing with numbers. Exercise 1.4. The question is question number 3. Suppose a 3-digit number ABC. Suppose a 3-digit number ABC is divisible by 3 so that ABC plus BCA plus CAB is divisible by 9. Okay. So once again I read the question. A 3-digit number ABC is divisible by 3. So already we have learned the divisibility rule of 3. What we will do, we will add the 3 numbers. If we get the addition, if the addition is equal to the multiple of 3, that number is completely divisible by 3. The same rule will apply here. Okay, first one, solution, I will try to take the proof. Proof, a number is divisible by 3, a number is divisible by 3, sum of the digits, sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Okay, look here, first one. A number is divisible by 3, sum of the digits is divisible by 3. The digits are therefore A plus B plus C. So how will you take up otherwise? So we are having ABC. So ABC is nothing but A plus B plus C. So the sum of this is multiple of 3. Means the sum of these three digits is always multiple of 3. Next one. Hence, so we are having ABC, BC and CAB, add them. So how will the BCA, B plus C plus A and CAB, C plus A plus B. Clear done? Later on, add these all numbers. How will you add? A plus B plus C, B plus C plus A, C plus A plus B. So totally three digits are there. A plus ABC, BCA, CAB. ABC we have written, A plus B plus C, BCA, B plus C plus A, CAB, C plus A plus B. Later on, how much will you get down? 3 times A plus 3 times B plus 3 times C. Later on, take 3 common. Remaining is what? A plus B plus C means the multiple of 3. So this is order. Multiple of 9. Correct? 3 and remaining number is there. So this total is equal to multiple of 9. Therefore, ADC plus BCA plus CAB is always divisible by 9. Clear? So it was to prove. So we have proved by taking the digits like the ABC. In the question only has given ABC. So later on we told to find out the sum of ABC, BCA and CAB is divisible by 9. So a number is divisible by 3. Sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Correct? First one, we just added the digits A plus B plus C. This is the rule of divisibility test of 3. BCA and CAB. Later on, add these three digits. So we get A plus A is 3A, B plus B, 3B, C plus C, 3C. Totally, how many are there? 3A are there, 3B are there, as well as 3C are there. Out of these three, take 3 common. Remaining is what? A plus B plus C. So 3 is there, the remaining number. If you multiply these two numbers, that number is equal to multiple of 9. That's why this is a multiple of 9. Therefore, ABC plus BCA and CAB is always divisible by 9. Okay, shall we go for the next question? I'll drop this. The next question is question number 5. Prove that question number 5. Prove that a 4-digit palindrome is always divisible by 11. Always divisible by 11. Okay, if you have read the question, prove that is there. Prove that a 4-digit palindrome is always divisible by 11. First one. So we'll take the proof. Yes. A four-digit palindrome is of the form A B B A. Means a 4-digit palindrome is of the form what? A B B A. Means if you read from the first to the last and or last to the first, the pronunciation should be same. A B B A, A B B A. Later on, sum of the digits. Some of the digits in the odd place. Okay, now tell me the sum of the digits is 1, 2, 3, 4. The sum of the digits in the odd place is A plus B will come. A is the first number and B is the third number. Later on, the sum of digits in even place. The sum of the digits in even place, what is that? 2 and 4, that is B plus A. The sum of the digits in odd place is A plus B. The sum of the digits in even place is B plus A. Later on, the difference between two digits. The difference between both the digits. Both the digits. How is the difference? A plus B minus B plus A. This implies A plus B sum of the odd digits, B plus A sum of the even digits. Later on. Okay, A plus B as this, in between minus sign is there. So minus into plus, minus B, minus into plus, minus A. So plus A minus A cancel, plus B minus B cancel. What we get? The answer is 0. Clear? Therefore, afford the palindrome. This is it. Palindrome is always divisible by log. So that is your final answer. So once again I'll repeat. Prove that a four-digit palindrome is always divisible by log. So I have considered a four-digit palindrome is what? In the form of ABBA. Instead of number, I have taken order. All the variables. First one, sum of the digits in odd place. 1, 2, 3, 4. Correct? Odd place means what all things will come? A and B. So A plus B. Next, the sum of the digits in even place. Even place means what? 2 and 4. B plus A. Later on, what we'll do? The difference between both the digits means A plus B minus of B plus A. Next, remove the bracket. A plus B, write as it is. Minus into plus, minus B, minus into plus, minus A. So plus A, plus B and minus B get cancel each other, the answer is 0. So already we have learned the rule, divisibility rule of Lovett. This is what? If we take the alternate sign, the sum is equal to 0 or multiple of Lovett. Here we got 0, 100%, the 4 digit palindrome is always divisible by Lovett. So in the next session, I'll take the magic squares like a 3 into 3 and 5 into 5. Okay. Thank you dear children. Have a nice day.